Hey rock stars, Steve aka Void here, and I want to welcome you to another episode of Pajama Jam, where I attempt to learn classic songs, riffs, and solos up to speed in 30 minutes or less live on camera. And tonight, I'm going to do it under the weather. So, welcome to the show. Let me know where you're watching from. Let me know that you can see and hear me clearly. I'm just going to play my guitar over here just to make sure everything works. Let me know where you're watching from, if you got your jammies on, and if you're battling a cold on account of baby germs like I am. So it's good to be back. It's been about a month since the last episode of Pajama Jam, and I've been really itching to get back to the show, and there's just been a lot of different things going on. Namely, my daughter's been sick. She's 20 months old. She's been at daycare for quite a while, and so that's just like a petri dish for bacteria. And so she came home sick, and then you know, pretty much everybody got sick at some point. So hopefully I make it through the episode. My voice makes it through this episode. It's funny because tonight's episode is tackling a song that is pretty complex. So it'll be interesting. I think there was one other episode where I did it under the weather. So we'll see how I do today. And that song tonight is, as you can see from this over here, it's YYZ by Rush. And I'm saying YYZ, not YYZ, because Rush is a Canadian prog rock band. And there's a fun fact about this song, actually. But basically, before we get to that, the song released in 1981, February 12th, 1981, off of Moving Pictures. It's actually two fun facts. Number one is check out this album, okay? So check out the album cover over here. So Moving Pictures, these guys are clever, as you'll see in fun fact number two. But fun fact number one, they thought that they would be super clever with the album title and Moving Pictures. So you have movers who are moving pictures, but then you also have the people being moved by the pictures, so they're moving pictures. People are watching them, and they are being moved by the pictures, so they are moving pictures. If you're going to describe the pictures, what kind of pictures are there? They're moving pictures. But then, one that I forgot, was then they went one step further, and behind, so on the back of the vinyl, and also on the, or on like the inside flap, they have this over here, which is they have basically a motion picture being filmed of the whole scene. How ridiculous is that? I mean, Rush is awesome, but who, like, that's ridiculous. The three levels deep, triple entendre, as they say. So that's fun fact number one. And nice, I see Brandon's here, seeing hearing clear on YouTube. Well, as clear as possible, because, you know, I have the frog in my throat. Jamming in your jammies there. Very cool. Awesome. All right, let me know in the chat. Let me know where you're watching from. Let me know if you got your jammies on, and that you could see and hear everything clearly. Cool. Joe is from Pittsburgh. Awesome. Welcome, Joe. Cool. I think first Pajama Jam. Very, very cool. All right. So the other part, the other fun fact about this song is, well, first of all, actually, who here has heard this song before? Because, you know, Canadian prog rock, as big as Rush is, some people might not know the song, and that would be even more reason to watch the episode, to be exposed to a new song. But YYZ is the airport code for Toronto. For anyone who's been to Pearson Airport, YYZ is the airport code for Toronto. And so what they did, these guys, these wise Canadian guys, what they did was they took the Morse code, out of all things. So they took YYZ and they took Morse code, and they basically put Morse code, they put the rhythm of the drums and of the riff to Morse code. Ba 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 ba. It sounds like Morse code. It's Morse code for YYZ. I don't know if you get geekier than that. It's pretty awesome, but I don't know if you get geekier than Morse code defining the rhythm of the drums and the guitar riff. Unreal. So, because you have Y would be long, short, long, long, bum, 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 and then another Y, bum, 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 and then Z or Z is bum, 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 long, long, short, short, unbelievable. So anyway, fun fact, we've got some moving pictures, triple entendre. We've got Morse code setting the riff. Just ridiculous. So the way that the episode works, if this is your first time at a pajama jam, basically, I'm going to go through the song. There's a few sections in the song that I'm going to learn today, or I'm going to attempt to learn. And there's absolutely no pressure for you to learn the song. What I want you to do is I want you to pay attention to how I'm learning the song, how I'm breaking it down, so that you could apply it to any song that you want to learn. Okay, that's what this show is all about. I was watching someone who has a good practice technique practice a song and learn it quickly, so you can model that and take that so you can learn songs faster. So no pressure, just I recommend sit back, relax, watch the episode, watch the ups and downs. Hopefully I can narrate as much as possible as I'm playing. I've got my lozenge over here. And let's talk about some of the prep that I did. So I've got my lozenge over here. I've got my tea over here. I've got some water. I've got a box of Kleenex over here. I've got now some of the musical stuff that I have. I have metronome on my phone. I also have the songbook. I have I quick scanned the star and starred the songbook. So I set up the stars on all the different sections. Okay, and that's so that when I look through the PDF, as I'll see in a second, I'm going to see those stars. So I'll know what parts I'm going to be learning. What else? I saw that it was 104 beats per minute on the tab over here. I also have a riff station with a backing track. Let's just make sure. Can you guys let me know if you could hear this? Can you hear this backing track? Just let me know if you could hear that. That would be very, very helpful because I'm going to be playing along to that backing track. Hopefully, if I could learn this. All right, let's see here. We've got Johnny in the house. Awesome. We've got Colleen. Welcome. We've got James. We got Bobby and we got Bruce. Welcome, everybody. Very happy to have you here. Very good to be back. So, I prepared all that stuff. I tuned the guitar. I listened to the track a few times before the episode started. I listened to it just to get it in my head. And I recommend that you learn songs that you love because that's going to make it so much easier for you to learn because it's embedded in your mind. You have an emotional connection with the song, so you're going to be able to map it out better. You already kind of have a bit of a head start, and so we're just kind of putting some moves down into our fingers. And so I highly recommend playing songs, learning songs that you love. Okay, and Rush used to be one of my favorite bands, and so YYZ, I heard this a lot. And so I know the song, I know what it's supposed to sound like. A little bit intimidated right now. I don't know what's about to happen, but we'll see. Hopefully with the good practice system that yours truly created, that I could break this down, chunk it down, and build it up to speed in 30 minutes or less. Now, disclaimer, I'm not playing the whole song. I'm going to be playing a few different riffs in here. I think there's four total, and I'm going to be aiming to play that along with the record. So that was pre-practice. That's what I did. Hopefully my voice doesn't give out. And it looks like the backing track is coming through okay. Awesome. Thank you. Thanks, Bruce. Thanks, Lance. Thanks, Brandon. Thank you, Colleen. Awesome. And thanks, Johnny. Cool. All right. I have to remember to cough that way, not this way. Okay. Cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the timer on the screen, the new and improved timer, and I'm going to see if I can beat this timer. All right. So wish me luck. When I start this, I'm going to... hopefully it actually like will translate back and forth to the different screens. Let me see. It should. So let's, I just didn't test that, but let's start the timer. I also have my cube timer over here where I'm going to set it for 5 minutes, probably 5 minute chunks to pace myself. I only have 30 minutes here. So let's get this thing going. Wish me luck. So I'm going to hit start here. All right. Yeah, okay, cool. So it works here. All right, so we've got YYZ, and here's the first section. So here, this part here is the main riff. Bum, 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 bum. That's the main riff. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to play just this part with something called no tempo practice. Where's my marquee tool? Okay, so with no tempo practice. All right. So I'm just going to go through this without worrying about timing or anything like that. Okay, so Okay, so basically this section here, this is one finger per fret, and I'm just going to, because I know what it's supposed to sound like, I'm just going to kind of put it into rhythm. So I did that with no tempo, but I'm going to do it with slow tempo. So slow, I can't make a mistake. So... Now that I did that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to... looks like the camera moved. Okay. So now that I did that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the fast practice formula, which is I have to play this part three times without making a mistake, okay, before moving on, before increasing the speed, the amount, or the complexity. So I did it once already. Okay, that's two. Cool. Now I'm going to set a timer for 5 minutes here because this repeats. Again, I know this song in my head. I know what it's supposed to sound like. So this just keeps going over and over and over, and I'm going to wait for a specific cue in the backing track. So I'm going to play this a little bit faster here. I'll probably have to do down up. So. Again, I know what it's supposed to sound like in my head. So that part's actually not the part that I'm, I think even years ago, I remember playing this part either on guitar or bass. So that's not going to be too challenging. This part here, it's right here, just making sure I get the right amount of shots here. Ba 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 ba. Okay, that's the same. And then ba 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 ba. Okay, so four shots or one. One, two, three, one, two, three, four. Okay, that's cool. One, one, two, three, one, two, three, four. Cool. So, whoops. So I made a mistake there. I'm going to try this again. That's one time. Now I'm going to do it again. Last time, I want to play this three times without making a mistake. Okay, I think I'm feeling pretty confident about that. I could actually probably put that to the record because it's only two notes. So let's see. Actually, so I made a little mistake in there. Okay, let's try this again. Cool. Now, I'm looking at the, at Riff Station right now. So I'm actually looking at the shots. You can see the actual shots here. Bum, 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 bum. So I'm looking at that just to make sure I'm tight with it. So let's see here. Okay, actually, let me do that one more time. So I made a mistake there. I'm going to try this three times in a row without making a mistake. That's two. Cool. Great. Okay. So that's that part. So that riff is done. I feel good about that. Okay. So I'm going to reset my counter. How did I do there? Oh, this thing's running out of batteries. Okay. So next, that's the first riff. I wasn't worried about. I mean, when I was a teenager, I think that I played this riff before, but not the ending. I just went ba da ba 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 da ba 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 ba. And again, because I know that it's that Morse code pattern that, again, like it's that, it's just, I know the song, I know what it's supposed to sound like. So that part was, okay, it's this part. This is the part. Oh boy. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go back to no tempo practice. I'm going to just see what notes are going on over here. Let's zoom in a little bit for you guys. Okay, so. Okay, let's see, same four, seven. So I'm just going through just to see if one finger per fret. Okay, so just I'm just double checking that the fingering here works. So okay, so that's actually, it's interesting. It's just like a scale. So if you're playing scales, it's probably better that you play YYZ by Rush. If you like Rush, if you like the song, it's just gonna be more productive to do something like that. So here, let's see, there's fast little, but okay, let's go. I did no tempo practice, now I'm gonna do slow tempo practice. So I'm gonna go so slow that I can't make a mistake. So let's go even slower actually. Okay, it's gonna have to be much faster than that. But I'm setting my 5 minute timer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same speed that I just played three times without making a mistake. I just did it once. So, okay, I did a no tempo practice. Then I did slow tempo practice. So slow, I can't make a mistake. No tempo has no pulse, no steady pulse. Slow tempo has a pulse, but I played so slow that I can't make a mistake. Now that I did that once, I'm going to aim to do it three times. So, okay, that's two. Okay, cool, that's three. Now, I've got my trusty, oh, it actually has the tempo there. Okay, that's good. That is good. So, what I'm gonna do is, so 116 is the tempo here. Let's hear that. I've got my metronome right here. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay, I'm not gonna get freaked out here. So, I'm going to do 81. Okay, so. Okay, now three times. Okay, maybe I'll palm mute it a little bit here. So that's two times. Okay, now after you do it three times without making a mistake, I usually move on. I increase the speed, the amount, or the complexity. For this, let's do the speed. So I usually go up 3 to 5 BPM. So here I'm going to do 5 BPM faster, 86. Okay, again. Two. Okay, that's three. I'm going to go to 91. Okay, and actually I'm going to double check the track in a second here. If I was having trouble with those first two notes, I would remove those first fast two notes there. I might have to when it gets faster. Okay, that's three times without making a mistake. I'm gonna go up by five. Actually, I'm gonna skip a couple of steps and let's see here what the speed is supposed to be. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna just look at this on the screen and play it slower on the screen here. So, two, three, four. Okay. Okay, that was a mistake, so I'm gonna reset the counter. Okay, and actually, let's get the metronome in here. Two, three, four. Riff station, man, that's awesome. Having the metronome count that was way better. Three, four. Okay, that's two. Okay, that's cool. And I'm just remembering the pattern here. because it's very like, it's like a scale. Okay, and again, I know what it's supposed to sound like in my head. So it's just working up the speed here. Okay, so this was at 140. Let's bump this up here. So I did it three times without making a mistake, and now I'm moving on. I'm increasing the speed. Okay, we'll do it like that. Okay. 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna sweat. Okay. 2, 3, 4. Okay, cool. That's, was that two? Oh man, I can't even remember. 2, 3, 4. Okay, that's not bad. It's like a scale. Okay, let's push it. Let's see how fast it is, because I want to just make sure that I get this all done in time. 2, 3, 4. Oh my god. Okay, let me see if I can get that fast. One thing you're going to see me do in this episode is that. Where I'm not just going to pick it, I'm going to strum it so I can get the pattern without any precision. Okay, so now. When I'm working up the speed, I'm just going to take the fretting element out, and I'm going to do this three times without making a mistake. So I'm removing the complexity. And I'm also playing only on one string, so I'm removing the complexity of having a string travel with a pick. Okay, so here, okay, let's see if that's a 2, 3, 4. I just have to play fast. I just have to play that fast and think fast. Let's do that again. 2, 3, 4. Okay, last time. 2, 3, 4. Oh man, that's a little tricky. It's a bit easier than I thought it would be, but I had to play it slow first to get that. And in this technique, that really helps. Okay, let's go back to no tempo practice. Let's go. Okay. Here. You'll notice that I do things three times without making a mistake. Okay, I got a boogie on this here. So there it goes. Okay, that should be okay. Now it's this. So let's see. No tempo practice. Yeah, it's just like little scales. So. Three, okay, so. Play so slow without making a mistake. So slow I can't make a mistake. So. Okay. It's two. Three. So I went no tempo to slow tempo, so slow I can't make a mistake, and then play that three times without making a mistake before moving on, which is playing it faster. Okay. I want to get this before the 15-minute mark. Let's increase the amount. So. That's actually not that bad. I was really scared of this part. Playing it up to speed is going to be a different story, but let's see. Okay, there's a mistake there. So I'm going to reset the counter. I'm going to go a little bit slower. Okay. That's two. That's three. Okay, let's push it. Let's see. Let's play with the record. A little slower. 2, 3, 4. Not bad. I'm looking at the screen here. I'm going to use my ears more. But I was looking at the screen just for those cues because there's just some breaks here. But let's try again. That wasn't bad. 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's not bad. Now, this metronome's kind of messing me up a little bit here. 134. Let's go up to speed. Let's give this a shot. Okay, and there's a little slide. Cool, that's actually pretty good. I'll try that with distortion in a second. Okay, but let's keep going. That's not bad. That was the scariest part. That was the part that I was really, really nervous about. Okay. I'm just going to take actually a quick little drink here. It's going to taste disgusting because I have Buckley's lozenge plus echinacea tea. Just knocked my tooth with a cup, with a mug. Awesome. All right. So, you guys, this is a little bit different than most episodes of Pajama Jam. I'm just really trying to focus as much as possible on the speed here. But is this helpful seeing me break this down where I'm playing it first slow tempo and then, or no tempo practice, then I'm playing slow tempo practice, and then I'm using the fast practice formula, which is three times without making a mistake before moving on, increasing either the speed, the amount, or the complexity. If I make two mistakes in a row, I've got to decrease the speed, decrease the amount, or decrease the complexity. All right, now let's get this next part going. All right, so. All right, it's all usually one finger per fret with rush riffs. Okay, let's actually get more coverage here. Let's see the next part. Ah. So because I know what the song's supposed to sound like, so I could probably do down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, down. Now, because of that, because I know that I can do the rhythm here. To save some time. Now, I just got an idea. I'm going to scroll down. Is this part easier? Yeah, this part's shorter. Let me do this first. And we'll close it out with the da-da-da-da-da-da because it's longer. So, bum, 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 bum. I might skip some steps here. No, I'll do no tempo. Okay, then, but I'll just do more. Okay. Okay. That's not bad. Let's go slow tempo. Not bad. Okay, that's slow tempo, so I'll do it again. That's one time. Cool. Okay, that's two. I did it with the wrong finger there. So I have to remember to bend with the ring finger. So it resets the counter. Okay. That's one. Two. Excuse me. Okay, not bad at all. So I'm getting coverage there. I'm using the fast practice formula. Play three times without making a mistake. Now let's do this part here. And I know what it's supposed to sound like. I really want to try getting this part down before the 10-minute mark. Okay, I see. Okay. Yeah, so again, I know I know what this is supposed to sound like. And it's not that complex. So I'm feeling pretty confident about that. I did no tempo twice there just to make sure, but I'm gonna do slow tempo. I feel pretty good about that. So now I'm going to play both. Hopefully I can get both by the 9-minute mark, and then I'm just going to jump in the deep end. okay, I feel good about that. I'm going to skip some steps here because I want to just make sure I can play that along with the record and it's sounding good. I'm not wasting too much time. And the other thing is, where is Riff Station? No, it's going to take me like 10 minutes to find Riff Station here. It's so many programs. Okay, all right, let's see here. Okay, I think it's right here. Okay. Good about that. So I'm going to jump in the deep end with that. I'm going to play all this stuff with distortion in a sec. Actually, maybe in a few minutes. I want to just make sure I can get all this different. No, wrong part. Okay, I'm a little bit behind schedule. Oh man. Okay, so. That should be good. Let's see. Right here. I'm remembering that based on zones. So I'm like playing one finger per fret wherever I can. And I'm just remembering what position I'm moving to. So for this one, it's fourth position to second position, fourth to second. Then this one is first to fifth, first to fifth. So it's that's how I'm remembering it. It's like I'm switching channels. Okay. All right. So that part there, I feel pretty good about that. Now, I'm glad that I did that because now I could focus on this. Ba ba da ba da bum bum. Ba da ba da ba da ba da bum bum bum. Okay. Ba da ba da ba da ba bum. Ba da ba da ba da ba da bum bum bum. All right. So let's now put this slow tempo practice. Okay. I'm gonna do down up down up down up down down. Yeah. So I'm just doing one finger per fret. Okay. That's one. Okay, I'm just gonna, oh man, I'm gonna have to jump in the deep end with this one. And I'm gonna have to trust that the next part, of course they switch it up. Man, where does the time go? One finger per fret, thank God. Okay, so I did it three times without making a mistake. Now I'm gonna do both together. Okay, so that's enough that I need to know there. Then the next part moves up, because again, I know the song, right? So I know that it repeats. So then, good, just the same pattern, cool. Of course, it's the same pattern. So what I learned here applies over here. And then I know there's one more part. That's right here. Because I know what the song is supposed to sound like, right? So never underestimate that. Yeah, I'm going to scrap this note right here. I don't care for that note. So I'm just going to go. So I'm doing just strumming it. Removing the complexity here so I can play faster. Okay, I'm gonna slow down a little bit. Three times I'll make a mistake. Okay. Oh man. And if I make mistakes, I'm just gonna keep going. So, da 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 dome. And sometimes what I do at this stage when I want to do something really fast, I just go with like kind of like no tempo, but I speed it up a bit. So I'm just kind of like going through it, but as fast as I possibly can, even with no steady tempo. So I could kind of ramp up some of it. that's not bad. Actually, you can kind of like, kind of fake it a little bit in that chromatic section. Okay. One mistake. That's two mistakes. I gotta slow it down. Three times I'll make a mistake, move on. Mistake. Okay. I'll take it. Okay, oh man, I'm gonna have to jump into the deep end here with these parts. Oh man, how fast. I'm kind of afraid to check how fast this part goes. Okay, let's go here. Just up the speed. Oh shit. Okay. Okay, so see how I'm using that? Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-bam, I'm strumming it. So I'm gonna see if I can get away with that. Okay, let's see, it's going. Okay. Cool. All right, let's slow it down just a little bit. Got 2 minutes left here. If I can play this part up to speed, then that's all the parts that I wanted to learn here, and then I'll see if I can do all of it together without the countdown. Okay, let's see here. We've got 1 minute left here. Typically, you wouldn't play faster right now, but I'm broadcasting and I really want to win. So let's see if this works. And I'll just see if I can crank on the mistake recovery if I have to. Okay, I'm gonna do that slide. No. Let's do one more time. I think I made it. Oh my god. Okay, let me just, I almost passed out there. This is the thing about this pajama jam. It's because I'm under the weather. I might pass out. And because it's dark here, I've got my pajamas on. Why not? Just get the pillow. I'll conk out. All right, I feel pretty damn good about that. Because also, if I did make a little mistake, I didn't sweat the small stuff. Play now, polish later. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just see, because I feel like I beat the timer. Because I learned all the parts, those four parts that I wanted to learn. So what I'm going to do, let's let this timer, let's let this finish. Let's see, I haven't seen the end of this video. 2, 1, and cool. All right, timer's done. All right, I think I beat the clock. Yes. All right, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the distortion on. We're going to have some fun. Oh boy. Okay. Any Rush fans over here? Definitely, I remember when I first saw Neil Peart throw the stick up and then just like continue the drum solo. It was like, whoa, that's crazy. 2112 is my favorite Rush record. But Moving Pictures is definitely solid. So let's see. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to consolidate these different parts. I'm going to play with distortion here, if that's cool with you. And I'll see if I can just string the parts together. And I'll see if I can play this along with the record. So, all right, let's get rid of this timer here. Let's get rid of the countdown timer. So, all right, let's see. Well, let me just double check that everything is cool with you guys. Colleen, amazing, sounds like tap dancing. Yes, a good demo of the process, awesome. We're being taught by master, oh, thank you so much. Hey Phil, this is crazy stuff. Awesome, hey Basher. Dan, welcome buddy, beast mode. And in LA, proudy man, thank you so much. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just review some of those parts. I have the tab over here, because now I'm stringing together a mount, and because my memory's a little bit off right now, because I'm a little under the weather, that's, by the way, a little bit of an advantage sometimes. And that's why I didn't cancel this episode. Because before I had to cancel the episode because my daughter was sick and I just was tending to her. But I didn't cancel tonight's episode because I also wanted to see. I remember sometimes when I was a teenager, when I'd stay home from school and I'd be sick, I'd play some of my best guitar when I was sick. And that's because my mind isn't getting in the way. I've got no energy. So the mental energy goes down. I can't be a perfectionist. So let's see. What's this? And actually, let me... so by the way, if you want to check this out, go to playfromday1.com if you haven't checked that out. If you want to, you want me to help you to do the same stuff but with songs you want to play, then definitely check that out. I'm going to get rid of this here just so you can see my guitar. And actually, you know what? Maybe I will. Maybe I'll put. Let's go to the switch cameras, and maybe I can put that back on there if that's cool with you. So, highly recommend checking out playfromday1.com. And let's get this going. So. That part's probably going to be fine. Let's see this. Just a quick review. Cool. That's so killer. What was the last one? Yeah. Everything sounds better with distortion. Okay. So, cool. Let me just see something really quick. This is probably going to ruin the picture completely. Yeah, it's going to ruin the picture. Okay, so I was just getting a little bit of glare. Okay, so that part. Okay, I feel good about that. Oh, that's funny. Sliding. Dodge the bend. Cool, and then I think it goes again. Cool, maybe I'll do the second half on another episode. But let's see if I can play along with the record. Okay, let's see. That's awesome, Ellie. We used to call this lab coat rock. Yeah, yeah, prog rock, definitely. That's awesome. Prog rock. This is definitely calculated rock. They have a lot of great songs that aren't as mathematical as this one. But let's see. Let's see if I can get this. Oh man, this is. I might not make it back. Okay. Hopefully I could hear everything. And you guys too. Okay. Let's try this again. We'll be right back. Okay, I don't know if that was clear or not on your guys' end, but yes, yeah, that was fun. Oh man, I love this song. It's a really good exercise. Like, if you love a band, I highly recommend just playing songs that you love, because this song is like an exercise. I feel my fingers burning right now, and this is definitely the more challenging song for sure. Like, my mind, with whatever brain capacity I have going on right now, I'm just thinking, what's the next part? What's the next part? Just thinking, like, changing channels. Okay, so I'm in this part here. Okay, so then the next one is like, then the next part, then the next part. Okay, and I'm just like switching positions. Okay, boom, I'm here. And then the next one, so I'm basically just switching channels in my mind, like a TV, and that really helped. So I don't want you to watch this and think, okay, cool, so I'm gonna play YYZ by Rush. If, let's just say, you still only know a few songs, and the point is you learn songs you love, and you already have a head start. That's the only reason. If I never heard this song, I wouldn't know how the different parts go. I've been listening to this song for like 20 years. So, I mean, I know how a lot of the different parts go. So now I'm just kind of putting it to my fingers, like, oh, here's where it goes, ba-da-ba-ba-ba-da-bum, or it goes, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-dum, or ba-ba-ba-bum, ba-da-da-da-dum. Now I know where those go. So I had a head start. So never underestimate that power. And also, listening to the song beforehand, pre-practice, man, if I didn't pre-practice properly on this one, then I would be in rough shape, okay? That wouldn't have happened. I wouldn't have been able to play. Not in 30 minutes. That clock was running fast. Okay. So hopefully you could see how, like, okay, so I had to skip a few steps, as the clock was running out. If that happens to you, just, you know, finish strong with with whatever you're working on. You don't have to rush to get to the finish line by the time the timer runs out, unless you're broadcasting a TV show in your pajamas and live, and you just really want to get that finish line. If you're just, you have half an hour to practice, then just finish with whatever you're doing, but use the fast practice formula. That's chapter 7 is going to walk you through how to practice very efficiently. Okay, practice less, play more is the name of my book. It's a bestseller on Amazon, thousands of copies sold, and lots of very, very happy readers who are just rethinking guitar. And I get a lot of hate, get a lot of people who, they haven't read the book, or even some people have read the book, and they don't quite get it, and that's fine. You're here, and you get it, and you know how the mind is really going to control the fingers, and making sure that you have a systematic way. I mean, I'm not going to say it's going to work for everyone, but I mean, I've seen enough. In the past 17 years, I've seen enough people who it's worked for and completely transformed their results. So check that out if you haven't already. Practice Less, Play More. You can pick it up on Amazon. You can go to playmoresongs.com. You'll get it there. And again, if you want me to personally walk you through how to do this with songs that you love, then definitely check out playfromdayone.com. There's a waiting list. Just add your name to the waiting list, and then we can see about getting you into the program when a spot becomes available for you, and that would be so cool to work together. For everyone here who works with me already and who has experienced some of the wins already, I'm very, very happy that you are in my life and that I get to coach you every day. Very, very excited about that. So, and I'm just going to drop the link here. I don't know if this is going to go through, but yeah, okay, cool. So that's the link if you want to check that out. So, let me just make sure I didn't forget anybody. And by the way, I could hang out for a few more minutes here. If you have any questions regarding guitar or the process, fast practice formula, anything with regards to guitar, please just let me know. I'll hang out for a little bit longer. And LA wants me to go to bed. Johnny, someone's going to be sleeping well tonight. Yeah, probably. That was pretty sweet. That was fun. It's just good to be back. So definitely very, very happy that that I broadcasted this. And Bruce, yes, you're welcome for going on sick or not. Yeah, I wanted to just make sure, because I'm also curious. I'm very competitive, so I just want to see if, you know, if my head is super heavy. I just want to see what happens. Because also, we get sick, right? We get sick. So we just want to make sure we can navigate that. Playing YYZ, playing a super complex song while you're sick, maybe it's not the best idea. But, you know, just know your limits. Be aware of your limits. And I know this strategy really well. So, you know, make sure that you learn the strategy and it'll do great things for you. Lance, I think the game I'm guaranteed to win on that song would be to just hold the guitar. That's awesome. All right, Colleen, we think you should go to bed and get some rest. Okay, cool. So as this frog in my throat is starting to go to sleep here, I am I'm going to get ready for bed here. And the replay will be available as soon as I end the broadcast on Facebook, on YouTube, on Periscope. Also, there will be a highlight video coming up soon where it's just the highlights from the episode. So check that out. That'll be on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll send out an email about that tomorrow. All right. So hopefully you enjoyed tonight's episode. I had a blast. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next one. Take